it bothers me, you know, when I see other people who are in these high-powered jobs, they're not even half the salesman that I am. Not even half. And I'm not trying to, you know, do myself a pat on the back, but I am that good. How are you? Yes.
First of all, the name of our company is the Bronze Baby Shoe Company. We've been doing this now since 1929. Not only do we do shoes, we've done Mickey Mantle's baseball cleats, Mr. Rogers' sweater. People call me every single day and say to me, I can get my kid's shoes bronzed for $69, and I'm going to send them away. And this is what happens.
Oh, my God.
Spray paint and plastic.
Oh, my God.
So my mother always told me three famous lines in life to live by. You get what you pay for.
Absolutely.
If it seems too good to be true, it usually is. And if you ever do business with the back of a magazine, a post office box, or today the internet, don't ever expect to get what the picture looks like. They think they're getting this.
Yeah.
They think they're getting this. They think they're getting that for $69. 15 layers of solid bronze, unconditionally warranted to look like that for the rest of your life. Even though I'm a professional, I've been doing this for 30 years, I make a living at this, I've made a great living at this, every single day I go out, I have butterflies in my stomach until I get that first order. Once I get that first order, I'm like, yeah! If you'd like some information, you can fill out a card.
Your name, address, and phone number.
Anything that has any kind of sentimental value to you, you want to preserve. I meet the middle of America, I meet outside of America, I meet inner side of America, I meet Americans. And this is what this product is, an American tradition for people who really like it.
I didn't know that people still did this.
How many years ago did you say it was done?
78 years ago.
Get out of here, you look too young for that.
Oh, come on, you need new glasses.
I just got new glasses. You know, when you also get oddball items from customers that have some sentimentality or some meaning, is really awesome. I've done fortune cookies, a finger. I had a woman who wanted a full body cast bronze when she was pregnant.
I wrote an order for a Vietnam vet for his boots, his combat boots. He was in a ditch, and he crawled up, and he got shot in the boot, and it was right by his heart. And he was saved by the boot, and we bronzed the boot with the bullet in the boot.
Oh, wow. Wow, wow, wow. Oh, my God, yeah, I remember. I almost got in trouble really bad for this one. I bronzed a bear skull. The way that we do our work is exactly the same way that we started in 1929. Nothing has changed. You see, the factory itself, it's like you're totally doing a Twilight Zone. We're throwbacks. We're all throwbacks. It's handmade in America. We don't make anything here in this country anymore. And to me, I take a lot of pride in knowing that not only am I selling a throwback product that's over 80 years old, but I'm selling a product that's been made the same way for 80 years, and it's made by Americans, for Americans, by Americans. I'm the only guy doing it, okay? And as far as I'm concerned, pride, wow, people talk about me all over the country. You know, hey, that guy, I remember meeting that guy. He's the guy that sells bronze shoes. How many times are you going to hear that from somebody saying that? What does that guy do for a living? He bronze baby shoes. So people always remember me. They remember me.
I grew up in Brighton Beach, Coney Island, literally a stone throw from the Cyclone and Nathan's.
So I used to work somebody's carnival games. You know, you throw the ball at the milk can. We used to stand up. And we used to go with the bear like this. We got a bunch of people here. We're going to knock one down. Well, the key to this whole thing was the two ones on the bottom are like lead goddamn bricks. And the one on the top is as light as a feather. It was the scam of all scams. You know, you say you make it in New York, you can make it anywhere. You make it in Coney Island, you can freaking make it anywhere. Man. Seriously. What I've learned is a keen sense how to identify something immediately. Within 30 seconds, I can identify what type of a person I'm dealing with, how I need to manipulate the situation because of how I had to do it here. Everything I had to do here is totally translated into everything that they do on the road. So I say, look over your shoulder every 5 seconds. The minute you stop looking over your shoulder, someone's going to take you. We've been taken before. I know how it's been done. I've been taken. Once you get taken once here in this area, you don't get taken again. Because you look over your shoulder and you know what's coming. You know what's going to happen. It's prepared me for every goddamn thing I've ever done in my life. And I would never exchange this for anything in the world. Period. Here we go. Thing about selling that I'm kind of disturbed about, because I know that I'm so good at what I do, is that I think I missed my calling in something else, that I could have made millions and millions and millions and millions and millions and millions of dollars selling something else. You know, like someone would be talking about, like going, we know that guy, he's the most renowned salesman in the world.
What do you know? We got a no-show.
Man, does that piss me off. I got about 12 or 13 different types of closes. One of the easiest ones is the ask for it close. Now, that's about as easy as I can make it. All you gotta do is ask for the order. Can I have the order? The either or close is one, would you like either the blue one or the red one? Which one would you prefer? Shut your mouth, you just got the order. You got the Ben Franklin close, the cautionary tale close, the final objection close. I used to memorize that. I'll tell you, everywhere I went, I took that piece of paper with me. I read it all the time. If I had to go to the bathroom, I read it on the bathroom. If I was at a game, I had it in my back pocket, I read it. I wanted to know those closes back and forth so easy, so back and forth, that there's no way that a customer could throw me off. That's how I became the salesman that I believe I am today. You know, I close 9 out of 10.
So we're doing the 2 shoes with the oval picture frame with the metal base and the antique bronze.
Yes. Right?
The pewter with the marble.
Right.
Did you want us to do any engraving with that? What's Charles' name and the birth date is 19.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. It's made up to the Bronze Baby Shoe Company.
The Bronze Baby Shoe Company, please. This is probably one of the loneliest parts of the job.
When you're alone a lot, you have a lot of time to think. And you think about a lot of things. You think of maybe what could have been, what should have been, what didn't be, you know, and you just, your mind is constantly moving. I wish there was a button that could shut it off, but it can't. When I was with my ex-wife, I looked forward to going on the road because I couldn't stand her and she hated me. Part of the reason why I travel so much is I had the opportunity to get away from my house. Now I want to be home. I'm finally with a woman that I love. I want to be with my gal, you know? I don't want to be on the road a lot, but I love what I do. So everything, I guess, is a trade-off in life. I'm to an age right now where it's about the quality of my life. And this is what makes me happy. So, you know, did I miss my calling? Yeah, but you know what? Am I happy? I've never been happier in my life.
I don't want to retire. If I see myself retiring, what the hell am I going to do with myself? I'm a salesman. I'm true and true a salesman. I see myself selling for the rest of my life to the last breath.